Look, we're not worried about the German army. We got enough troubles of our own. To the right, General Patton. To the left, the British army. To the rear, our own goddamn artillery. And besides all that, it's raining. And the only good thing to say about the weather, it keeps our air corps from blowing us all to hell because it's too lousy to fly. Verstehe?
Yeah. Okay.
See you in hell.
Vengeance is mine.
And that's the name of the game when it comes to the Dirty Dozen.
Telly Savalas, Ernest Borgnine. Dirty Dozen, the deadly mission.
Hello and welcome back to the B-Movie Rollout. Today we're talking about more Dirty Dozen sequels.
Last year I reviewed The Dirty Dozen Next Mission, which was the cheaply produced, made-for-TV sequel to the original 1967 classic. In short, this TV special is awful, mostly due to its atrocious writing. Half the movie is not just lines, but entire scenes lifted from the original movie.
Apparently, there was still a demand for a follow-up to The Dirty Dozen some 18 years later.
And apparently Next Mission brought in some ratings, because two more TV sequels were released the following years. Lee Marvin did not reprise his role as Major Reisman, as Next Mission was one of his final roles before he died. To replace him, the producers returned to the original film's cast and decided on Telly Savalas. They should have went with Charles Bronson.
Bronson, what were you doing in 1987?
I was making a sandwich.
All kidding aside, I actually really like Telly Savalas. But is he enough to save the series? Let's find out. Here's The Dirty Dozen, The Deadly Mission. Roll it!
We open with Savalas' character, Major Wright, leading an attack mission. Their goal is to capture Mussolini, but he's already left town.
That's not Mussolini.
After the credits, Wright is assigned to his... deadly mission.
There are 36 canisters of an experimental but deadly nerve gas in a monastery in France. We want them taken out before they can be launched by those new rockets. There are 6 scientists, top experts in chemical warfare, brought in from the occupied countries. We want them rescued from that monastery. You'll bring them out of France. My idea is that you start finding another Dirty Dozen.
So Wright starts assembling his new team.
I think you're a little too old for this project.
I'm not too old, Major.
That's rich, coming from the 65-year-old Telly Savalas.
Aside from Ernest Borgnine as the general, the cast are all nobodies. But you B-movie fans might recognize Randall Tex Cobb. He was in Uncommon Valor, Miami Vice, some other stuff. He was a famous athlete before he got into acting. Kind of like Jim Brown in the original movie.
Well, what makes you think you can be a black hero?
I'm an ex-football player.
Then, like clockwork, we get a scene ripped off from the original movie.
Come on, stick that knife in. You can do that.
Come on.
Major, I don't want to do this.
Go ahead, lunch.
Major, I'll kill you.
Stop it. Don't tell me what to do. I'm giving you
I don't like to be pushed.
Get off us!
Major, don't. Don't push me.
I'm pushing you, Swede, because I want to find out where you're coming from, all right?
Stick him! Stop him!
Put him away, Swede.
Get him, Swede.
Lunge. And what happens when the crowd comes along and shoves this steel through to the back of your head?
Next, we see a training exercise that features the dumbest death scene in a movie ever.
I can't get this up.
Here, keep going, Helen. Or you'll get us all.
No.
Helen, keep going. Stay down. What are you doing?
What are you doing?
Although Lee Marvin was the best part of Next Mission, Telly Savalas proves to be the right tough guy actor to replace him, as he's great during the training scenes.
Oh. Welcome to World War II.
In another scene ripped directly from the first movie, the Major arranges for a group of prostitutes to visit the men on the last night before the mission, but he doesn't participate.
Aw, that's too bad. He didn't get to join in during the first movie either.
I saw those filthy strumpets!
You're turning this place into a bottomless pit of vice!
Oh yeah, because in that movie, he was playing a rapist.
But you know, there's a rapist in this movie too. And they still let him stay. They even call attention to the fact that he's a rapist.
He's a rapist and he murdered a whack. You think he belongs here?
You all belong here. But do me a favor. Keep an eye on him anyway.
What are you doing?
So they land in France, make contact with the resistance, and plan their attack. But first, we get an attempted rape scene.
Oh, great. Just what this movie needs.
When it's over, I kill Frontenac myself.
They launch their attack, but it soon becomes a rescue mission when Wright finds out that the French scientists are being held hostage with their wives and children. After the poison gas is destroyed, Wright infiltrates a Nazi hotel to rescue the last remaining scientist. They make it out in an airplane, just like the last movie. But this time, the rapist stays behind and sacrifices himself.
What a hero.
And with that, the deadly mission is over.
I must say, it was certainly better than the last one.
Don't get me wrong, this still isn't very good. But the set design, action sequences, and cinematography are all better than what we saw in Next Mission. And while Telly Savalas is clearly too old and fat to be playing an active duty major, he's still just as much fun to watch as Lee Marvin was. Maybe even more.
Welcome to World War II.
Again, this movie's not very good, but it is a step in the right direction. So, do you think we will finish strong? Here's the Dirty Dozen, the Fatal Mission. Roll it.
The opening credits show us a pretty predictable cast. Telly Savalas, Ernest Borgnine, and a couple of bit players are back, and the newcomers include a couple of more ex-athletes, like John Matuszek, who you know as Sloth from Goonies. And then there's Eric Estrada.
Wait, Marco is in this?
Okay, Master Lou, come and get a shot of vitamin M!
Hi-yah! Oh, okay. You want some. You want some of the glowing.
And Ernie Hudson.
Whoa. The chances of this movie being awesome just went way up.
Major Wright and his men are in occupied Denmark to meet with a German defector who is smuggling out some secret plans for what the Nazi High Command is supposed to do in case they lose the war. Unfortunately, he is killed by a German patrol before he can pass on the information. Basically, the Allies already know Hitler's post-war plans. A group of Nazi elites have been chosen to start a Fourth Reich from within the Middle East.
The new Fourth Reich.
The movie never says exactly how this is supposed to be done.
Major Wright's mission is to assemble yet another Dirty Dozen to assassinate this group before they reach Istanbul. Ernie Hudson plays one of the new recruits, and his first appearance is awesome.
I don't care if he's shooting at his own guys. Ernie Hudson is awesome no matter what.
I'm gonna go up there and make a deal. And I'm also gonna make a promise. Make sure you don't break it. Do you understand?
You understand that? Do you understand?
Do you understand that, Kelly?
Yeah.
Surrender, and I promise you, you'll be training with the men in the morning.
Okay.
Much like the squad in Next Mission, this new group harbors a lot of resentment towards Major Wright. Plus, we find out one of the new guys is an informant.
How? They're under heavy guard at all times.
Well, this informant must be a pretty good double agent, because he manages to assassinate the only one who can speak German. Since there's no time to find a replacement, Lieutenant Campbell volunteers to take his place.
A woman in the Dirty Dozen. How progressive.
That she's an officer. And any order she gives will be obeyed immediately. Is that clear?
Yes, yes sir!
Even if she wants to take advantage of us, sir?
Ugh. Never mind.
Once again, the men are treated to hookers and boots.
Did he not get one for Campbell? Rude?
After landing, they attempt to cross German lines by disguising themselves as mourners at a funeral.
I will open it. Yeah. Nice.
Ernie Hudson is awesome!
After they pass the border, they seize a bridge and attack the train carrying the Nazi commanders. Once they capture the Nazis, Wright decides to hold them prisoner until they make it out of Nazi territory. When a rail car blocks the train's progress, Wright discovers who was betraying the group.
Only Colin saved me the trouble.
Marcos never really was good at following orders.
Are my methods unsound?
I don't see any method at all, sir.
Are you an assassin?
I'm a soldier, sir.
You're not. You're an errand boy sent by grocery clerks to collect a bill.
See you in hell.
They attach the tanker full of gas to the front of the train and press on, but the Germans have set up a blockade. The Nazis open fire as our heroes leap off the train. The train bashes its way through the blockade, and we are treated to a series of spectacular yet nonsensical explosions, as all the Nazis are killed.
Although it's fun to watch, it is still very stupid. Much like the movie itself.
The Fatal Mission is probably the best of the Dirty Dozen sequels, but this really isn't saying much. None of these movies can hold a candle to the original, but at least they seem to steadily get better. Deadly Mission and Fatal Mission are both noticeably better than Next Mission, and that is primarily due to the budgets. The Telly Savalas sequels feature better sets, better action, and a better cast. And as much as I love Lee Marvin, I couldn't help but notice his open disinterest in working on that project. Telly Savalas, on the other hand, appears enthusiastic and delivers an engaging performance. He's easily the best element of these films. The production value behind the Savalas films is also a major improvement over Next Mission, as these films were shot on location, while Next Mission was restricted to cheap TV sets. I imagine Next Mission was released to gauge whether there was still an interest in the Dirty Dozen franchise, and the next two were meant to capitalize on that interest. So would I recommend any of these movies? Not really. Maybe The Fatal Mission, but only if you're a fan of Telly Savalas and World War II movies. Plus, you've already seen the original Dirty Dozen, as well as Kelly's Heroes.
Given how many great World War II movies there are, I just don't see why anyone would bother with these.
And this wasn't the end of the franchise either. There was a Dirty Dozen TV series released after this.
I am not gonna watch that. I've already got too much TV ahead of me. Join me next time, and I'll tell you about it.
I got PhDs in 4 scientific disciplines.
Really?
Why do you think they call me Dr. Quinn?
I just thought that was a nickname. You know, like Dr. Dre. East Side.
In the Dirty Dozen. How progressive. Fuck off. Go on.
Get out of here. No. Well, you want to host the show?